Fengshui Menhao, today we're continuing on with our family topic, and the question is, 你家有几个人? 你家有几个人? I'll put the pinyin here for you just to help initially. We know that 几 is the question word for numbers. We've had before, 你几岁, for how old are you? And we've talked about 个, the measure word for people in Chinese. 几个人, how many people? We also talked about 有, in our last video, for to have, and 家, family. 你家有几个人? So how many people in your family? We're going to look at a slide in a moment, but this is the structure. So the person goes here, and then you would ask, 家有几个人? So, 你 could change to another pronoun, like 他, and, or a name even. And then you would put the appropriate response here for pronoun or person's name. All right, so if we have 你家有几个人, then we change 你 for 我, and everything stays the same, except 几 gets changed for the number of people. Let's have a look at an example in the next slide. All right, so here we are. 你家有几个人? Have a look at the image that's about to come up. And here we have 一二三, 三个人, three people. So the response would be 我家有三个人. All right, 我家有三个人, there's three people in my family. All right, if I asked you the question, 你家有几个人, what would be the response for this image and the amount of people? 很好, that's correct. 我家有四个人, 我家有四个人. Just while we're on this answer here and the question too, the 个 here can be replaced by 口, which you learned in one of our earlier topics, 口 for mouth, but it's also another measure word for people. All right, the next one, we'll just do one more, then you can do the rest on your own by going to the Google slide link. So the question, 你家有几个人? And for this answer, how would you respond? 一二三四五. So we have five people here in this family. So 一二三四五, 五 will go here. 我家有五个人. 很好. All right, there's a couple more that you can practice with in our Google slide. If you have any questions, don't forget to ask me. 同学们,再见. 同学们,